Zealand has a long and proud railway heritage. Currently owned by KiwiRail, the country has over 150 years of history, and part of it is the many preservation groups operating steam-hauled trains throughout the land. In this video, we focus on operations in the North Island. We start off in New Zealand's premier heritage train experience, the Glenbrook Vintage Railway, south of Auckland. The railway has many locomotives, including JA 1250 Diana, which has recently started undergoing a major overhaul. We look back at her scenes of operation during her last days in steam.
Wave the green from the platform.
Thank you.
cracking too.
As 1250's last fire was raked out, a new one was lit in Mainline Steam Trust's JA1275, currently stored at the GVR workshops. 1275 was returned to service for a very special weekend, to commemorate the engine crew who lost their lives at Tangawai on Christmas Eve 1953, when a torrent of water and rocks, known as a laha, struck the rail bridge moments before the Wellington to Auckland Express plunged into the river. We take a full behind-the-scenes look at this event, as the train prepares for the weekend and makes its way south.
We'll be right back. So it's a long story, really, but I could shorten it down. Christmas Eve 2015, I was rostered to drive a freight train down the trunk, and one thing led to another. Trains ran late, and I ended up taking a rental car down to pick up the train at Tangiwai. On the way down, I had a wreath with me from the Te Rapa branch of the RMTU that I was going to drop off at the memorial. And when I got to the memorial, Bob Norling was there. Bob Norling's a local of Awakuni and one of the lead organisers for the event itself. Back then we started talking, or he approached me and we started talking about a memorial stone for the engine driver and fireman, and it was going to be a really small $2,000 stone. And he approached me to see whether or not the RMTU might be interested in funding it. From that day, he put me in charge with Callum Mahey, who's from West Coast Memorials, whose father was on the train that night. And between Bob and Callum, they'd been working on this plan for that memorial. Really, from there, it just sort of snowballed into the event that it was, which saw it going from a $2,000 plain memorial stone to a complete rejuvenation of the memorial site and the event for the unveiling and the new design of the memorial that's there. So it sort of snowballed from that night, and that's eventually how other groups like Kiwi Rail came on board as a generous sponsor for the event, and the Lions clubs, various Lions groups throughout New Zealand and other organisations. So prior to the train running, we had to do some testing and certification on 1275. This was undertaken by our partners for the event, Mainline Steam. So they had their boiler recertified and the locomotive recertified for the event.
Okay, all good to go.
So the process for getting the trains to and from Tangiwai for the event was logistically quite a big effort by both the Glenbrook Vintage Railway and Mainline Steam. Working really closely with Kiwi Rail. So from the start, we had to get carriages from Glenbrook certified to run on the national network. Then we had to recertify the J1275. J1236 from Wellington was going through its certification process. So there were a lot of aspects really hinging on very short notice to get up and running for the event. Then, of course, there was the ticketing, and that was all handled through the GVR RES club rooms. And so we had the Palmerston North train to advertise, market and sell, as well as the Glenbrook train. So there were two markets and multiple trips by our volunteers down to Palmerston North to advertise that and whatnot.
My part in the preparation for the trip to Tangiwai was to get the carriages prepared and signed off for the network. The involvement in that was having the carriage inspected by myself and an independent inspecting engineer, and our peer reviewer from down Wellington, which was quite a lengthy involved process. Each of the carriages, which there were six, had to be looked over and then signed off and ready in preparation for the trip.
All good.
It takes a lot of teamwork and a good team of volunteers, which we're lucky enough to have here at the Glenbrook Vintage Railway. This involves washing carriages, getting the cars all cleaned from top to bottom on the outsides, cleaning of the insides of the cars, such as the windows, seats, floors, and bits and pieces, and also preparing the car as in that everything's in there for the trip for passengers' comfort, such as food, teas and coffees, and bits and pieces, which on the day we have a team of volunteers that do a really good job at doing that, and things right down to making sure the toilets are all set, cleaned, and that all the retention gear is all set up for a trip so everyone has an enjoyable day.
Yeah.
this being a joint trip between the Glenbrook Vintage Railway and Mainline Steam, we had to get the Mainline Steam in to certify JA1275, which is currently in storage at the Glenbrook Vintage Railway. This involved Lindsay and his team, and Mike College and the boys to come in and do the pit inspections on JA1275 for the network, which involved wheel readings, checking over the locomotive, all over, and getting everything tested, brake and bits and pieces. It involved about a weekend or two before the excursion for the engine to be steamed up and run on the Glenbrook Vintage Railway, just to make sure everything was working fine, and for the crews to make sure they're familiar with everything on board, and then yeah, everything was all set to go.
So since the return of steam to the main line in 1985, there's been many steam excursions run by the various preservation groups, and as more and more steam engines are preserved, more and more of them have run on the main line. In the latter years, there have been a declining number of steam certified crews, guys that were originally certified to operate machines full-time for the NZR. Fortunately, there have been a few of us who were brought up through the heritage or the various heritage groups and gained our certifications under that and worked for Kiwi Rail and are able to now operate these on the main line. So I'll be one of the two locomotive engineers on JA1275 leaving from Hamilton. There'll be myself and Richard Norton. My role is to take the train from Hamilton down to Owakuni on the 6th of May and then from Owakuni to Tangiwai on the 7th of May for the memorial. Thank you. say that all the local engineers that drive trains over that piece of track, and indeed throughout New Zealand, feel a deep connection with any crew that's been affected by an accident or killed on the job. Tangiwai has a deep connection with the crews in Palmerston North and Turapa. It's a section of track that we both operate over. So the link between the RMTU and Tangiwai is through local engineers of those areas. And so when the opportunity came up to be a part of this event, the RMTU were only too more than happy to be a part of it. So on the day of the event, both trains will arrive at the Tangiwai memorial site. They'll be transferred down to the memorial where there'll be a service being conducted and an unveiling of the actual memorial itself. At some stage during the day, JA1275 will go onto the bridge and blow its whistle in a mark of respect over a minute's silence for the after the unveiling of the memorial. And this should be followed by various presentations by dignitaries, VIPs and ministers from the government coming along. And then everybody should be getting back on their train and heading off. Thank you.
Today to this very special place, to this very special event. Distinguished guests, we are here in remembrance of the tragic events of Tangawai that will never be forgotten. To the families of those who passed, and to the various groups that are present who have made a contribution over a long period of time to this place, greetings, greetings, greetings to you all.
Today, we unite with Wayne Bunsen and the RMTU to share in the remembrance of our forefathers who lost their lives in the line of duty. And a special hello to my colleagues from Kiwi Rail who travelled here in big numbers today to mark their respect. Thank you.
As we have observed on Anzac Day, often the very worst of circumstances brings out the very best in New Zealanders. Tangawai was such an event and proves yet again, in times of tragedy, the courage of Kiwis rises to meet any challenge.
But today means more to us than closure for the events of the past. Lance died here, but his body was never recovered. And our Nana never gave up hope of finding him. This memorial for us will also represent his final resting place and a focal point for us and future generations. We hope that in the years to come, the people who come to this place will not only reflect on the tragedy that unfolded here, but will know the story of these two brave men who made the ultimate sacrifice all those years ago. Thank you.
Absolute success. It was wonderful to see all the various parties working together. And ultimately, we couldn't have done the families of engine driver Parker and Fireman Redmond's families any prouder.
Off to Auckland we go!
Yeah, it was great. The trip from our end ran very well, very professionally run by the team. Good to see that both groups, Glenbrook and Mainline Steam, work well together and a good team effort. And the punters on board, the people that were the passengers on board the train, enjoyed themselves and had a good time. So, no, great to see and well done to everybody.
Another 11 months left on 75's boiler ticket, the opportunity was taken to haul shuttle trains around the King Country for the Otrahonga Steam Fest. Months later, 75's last mainline outing was shuttle services over Easter weekend for the Whangarei locals. This was the first time a steam locomotive had travelled over the rusty rails of the North Auckland Line since 2013. The shuttles were highly successful, bringing awareness to the public about rail and its future in the Northland region. Down in the lower half of the North Island, Mainline Steam's JB1236 has been busy since its return to service in 2017, hauling trips to Pahiatua for passengers to visit the Tui Brewery, as well as trips up the main trunk line to the Chateau Whangarei on Mount Ruapehu near National Park.
Thank you. just knew he had to chuff and puff to put things right.
Sir, I will shut Gordon to the steamworks. Victor will make sure his funnel is free and his firefox fizzes. Then, Gordon can take you on the tour of Sodua, and I can be really useful.
Sir Topham Hatt was happy.
WW644 was taken out of service for an overhaul, which included a brand new boiler built by RCI Energy in Denneberg, the largest built in New Zealand for quite some time. In replacement, sister engine WW480 was placed back into service after a 10-year overhaul, which also included receiving a brand new boiler.
Glenbrook Box. Yeah, permission to proceed from Pukewaru to Glenbrook.
The driver, right away. Thank you.
In this time period, Lindsay Baker of Mainline Steam was busy completing the overhaul of J1211, stored at the GVR, to operate in Auckland City as the North Pole Express over Christmas. The train ran many shuttles over the two weekends between the old Auckland station and the Transdev depot at Whangarei. Down south on the route to Woodville, we see Steam Incorporated's JA1271 on a popular day trip to the small town. On the same route through the Manawatu Gorge, we see Fielding and District Steam Rail Society's F163 on a special rail fans excursion, followed by shuttle services the following day.
Woo!